If you are into electronics, then you probably already know that an oscilloscope is an indispensable tool when it comes to understanding circuits or creating your own. But my Rigelscope here, or its improved successor, is not really worth the $400 if you just want to measure the duty cycle of your PWM signal and don't care for the fancy mathematical functions like FFT or, for example, cursor control. Thankfully though, cheap $20 oscilloscope kits can be found nearly everywhere nowadays and they offer decent features for their price. So in this video, let's find out whether such kits are really worth it or whether you should throw them out the window. Let's get started! First off, let's have a look at the insides of the package. We got one bag with plenty of components to solder, a BNC to alligator clips test lead, a 2.4 inch TFT LC display, and finally the main PCB, which has an ARM-based STM32F as a core. But what I missed inside the package was a manual, or some kind of instructions. I found those eventually on the site of the original manufacturer, JYT Tech. And after printing them out, I sorted my components into separate piles and turned on my soldering iron. The chisel tip I'm using here is not the best one for the job, but through the help of a steady hand, tweezers, and tons of patience, the SMD soldering was not that difficult. Simply put a bit of solder on both pads, bring the resistor near them, solder one side in place, and then the other one. By heating up both pads, fast alternating, the component almost finds the perfect spot by itself. I used this schematic to identify which resistor value belongs to which pads, but you don't have to do this. I simply ignored the fact that JYT Tech offers a surface mount assembly guide. That is also the reason why I soldered the op-amp IC incorrectly during my first try. I had to flip the orientation around at the end of the build. Genius, I know. After all those end parts, I measured the resistance of the through-hole resistors, put them in their fitting place, soldered them to the board, and snipped off the excess leads. This procedure was pretty much the same for the capacitors, inductors, transistors, switches, and all the other complementary parts. After 3 hours of this madness, I soldered male headers to the TFT display and added two additional wires to the PCB in order to power it through my lab bench power supply, which was set to 9 volts. After a first successful voltage check, I shorted the jumper 4, plugged in my display, and enjoyed the first boot up of my new oscilloscope. On the left side, we can see the switches for the coupling modes and the sensitivity. In case you didn't know it yet, the AC coupling removes the DC component of your signal and the ground coupling connects your signal input to ground, which is a good opportunity to adjust the line to the middle of the display. But tuning the offset, the trigger voltage or the horizontal position is rather slow and sometimes even annoying because of the 4-button control. The two sensitivity switches allow a voltage range of 10 mV up to 5 volts per division, which is definitely good enough for hobbyists. The time base goes down up to 10 microseconds per division, but to give you a more practical example, let's connect the alligator clips to my frequency generator. As you can see, working with 100 kHz signals is still possible, but not a pleasure. The built-in measurement readouts also seem to work fine with this frequency. But as you go up to 200 kHz and beyond, it's starting to act a bit crazy and is certainly not usable for measurements. A standard DSO, on the other hand, would have no problem with that. But for simple things like finding out the duty cycle of your Arduino or other low-frequent periodic signals, it does the job just fine. It can even save one reading and spit it out whenever you want, which is a nice bonus. Okay, let's move on to turn on or off operations, like charging up a capacitor. I simply changed the trigger mode to single and set the trigger voltage to around 9 volts. Now if I charge the capacitor without a resistor, the output of my two oscilloscopes are pretty similar, but once I started to charge it slowly through a resistor, the $20 kit refuses to trigger correctly. And even if it does trigger, I cannot change the time base during the hold mode, which is a pain in the ass because this way I have to scroll through the horizontal position and that takes forever. But all in all, I do like the kit. For $20 you get a lot of features which are not only helpful doing hobbyist electronics projects, but also a great preparation when it comes to using the real deal. And with its low current draw of roughly 110 milliamps, it can easily be powered by a 9-volt battery to make it portable, which might be a future project. Anyway, until then, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Check out the description if you want to buy one of those kits and support my channel simultaneously. Stay creative and I will see you next time.